this evening to talk about the budget. It has been a long process. It seems longer this year than in previous years. And the reason that I say that is in preparation for the budget, Brockton took a very active role in what they call the Chapter 70 review over 2 years. You've heard me talk about being present, and I want to thank my Chief Budget Officer, Alder Petronio, who truly was present throughout the state, constantly talking about the needs of the Brockton Public Schools and positioning us well to have a say in changes that needed to take place in a very antiquated formula for funding public education. Unfortunately, we were disturbed, to say the least, that when the Chapter 70 Review Commission made the recommendations around November, the governor chose at this point in time not to take into account any of the recommendations of Chapter 70. Instead, late February into early March, we were faced with a new formula for our low-income students, the direct certification. I thank the council. I won't go into it at length this evening. You joined us in February with Jay Condon and Alder Petronio going over for us what the impact would be this year on our budget. After that, I want to also talk about the support that we got from our state legislative delegation, making sure that they were front and center as the budgets went through the House, the Senate. We still do not have a fine budget, but they were continuing to address these stresses that this put on our budget. So in talking again about the superintendent recommended budget, I will tell you my recommended budget was about $178 million, which in the end, I again thank the mayor for reaching full foundation. And as he stated earlier this evening, that is something that we can only go back about 11 years. We're not sure when the last time was that we actually had somebody reach full foundation. And this truly was the year that that needed to be done. The school committee took a look at the superintendent's recommended budget, came up with $175.1 million. The mayor reaching full foundation brought us to $167.4 million. And the shortfall at the time that we had been dealing with, and I want to thank my school committee for a lot of hard work, a lot of meetings, a lot of discussions. And although we're here this evening to talk about our budget, we still have a lot of work ahead of us this summer as budgets are finalized with the city and the state. So again, in looking at non-med school spending, let me just talk about that a little. Our requested budget this year included a couple of changes. We had a coordinated program review this year looking at our special education department, our bilingual department, our tech department, and basically one of the things that they talked about were some corrective actions, and it actually included adding a number of vans for our special needs students, making sure that they're getting to school at an appropriate time to make sure that they have a certain number of hours in their day. We also had to take into account the possibility of a charter school coming into the city needing additional transportation. So you will see our requested budget under non-net at $8.99 million. The current appropriation is $7.56 million. And our shortfall there is $1.43 million. One of the things that we're looking at, as I said, we still have some things that are moving pieces as far as the state calculations coming in. And as the mayor mentioned to you, we will be watching any additional funding coming in. We've heard, again, this money from the McKinney-Bento. I know the mayor in the past has given that money to the Brockton Public Schools. It looks like there could be some additional money in the budget coming through, and we will continue to look at those amounts. We also look at efficiencies with looking at our transportation for our buses and our number of students that are taking the buses. So that is our non-med school spending. When I refer to the budget barometer and the work that the school committee is doing, I'll try to encapsulate this by just talking about, again, once the budget was finalized, and we still had a deficit. One of the things that we did was we made a decision to send over 93 reduction in force notices. And that has to take into account. When you talk about 93, I will remind you that last year we sent out about 120 notices. Of that, there were 60 positions that did not come back in this fiscal year. So we were short 60 positions in our teaching and administrative force. This year, when we sent out 93 reduction in force notices, it takes into account those people coming back from leaves, alternative career leaves. There were people that were actually ripped last year that had an option 2 years in. If they took a job in another district, they still could come back to our district this year. So because of those moving pieces, the administrators that were red circled in their job, meaning if they were going to become as administrators, they went back into the teaching force. So all of that has a so-called bumping effect. So with the 93 notices that have gone out, in the end, at this point, there will be a total elimination of 59 positions. So out of those 93, I think 34 are already funded, and once we get through the process now, we'll start to be bringing them back very quickly before our last day of school, which is a half a day on June 20. We also had 13 retirements that were not filled, and total administrative positions about 11 that were not filled in this budget. If you also look at some ways that we reduced the $7 million deficit, we had pre-buying of supplies and materials from our FY16 budget, pre-buying our special education out of district tuition costs, which are allowed to do for the first 3 months of the fiscal year. So that totals $2 million. We also had an early retirement incentive, $606,000, and that allows you again to take off some of your top paid employees and bringing back lesser paid employees. Do not fill the firm on early retirement, $489,000. Our regular retirement, $280,000. And that reduction of elimination of teaching positions over $1.4 million. You'll also note